there's multiple levels of preparing a homily. So I think the first thing we have to talk about is the source material for a homily, which is generally the scriptures. The first part about making a good homily is that it would be somewhat based on either the readings of the day or the scriptures, if you're preaching on that particular, or if it's a feast day, on the event of Pentecost or something special. So you have the scriptural element, but then you have, what is a homily about? Homily is about it's not a scripture class. You're not teaching people. What you're doing is you're crystallizing the truth, crystallizing the meaning of what the story is about as a way to help us understand what will help us today. So it's the connection between the scriptures and today. I mean, famous preachers say you preach with the Bible in one hand and the newspaper in the other. That it's not a scripture class. And if someone says at the end of a homily, boy, that was very good exegesis, bad homily. It's a good scripture class, but not a good homily. And then how do you take your experience, the experience of God, and the experience of the community, and put them all in a blender? So you have some stories, you have relationships, and then you have whatever your theme is. And to try to keep, you know, within, young preachers sometimes want to say, give the whole salvation history in one homily. So I always say, stick to one point and really develop it. Stay with the idea, develop the idea. Then if you want to use a story or an illustration, that's fine. Now, this is where homiletics becomes very important. The writing and the preparation of the homily is only part one. Part two is how then you present the homily at public space. If I had a text and I'm just reading the text and every now and then looking up, I'm not engaging the people. I'm certainly not embodied. And basically it's radio. So why not just stay in the sacristy and broadcast the homily? We don't need to see you. You know what I mean? Just read it that way. But it would be a disembodied voice. Here we have human encounter. That's what the liturgy is about, the encounter of God with the people. So here we have the written text, or the idea of the text. Doesn't have to be, not that you follow the text perfectly or have it memorized, but you embody it and you know how to do it. But then you have to do it. Then your voice, your excitement, your eyes, your gestures, how do you bring people in? That's part of being a preacher. And so standing at a lectern and using robotics doesn't work. So I think we talk about good preaching. Good preaching has good content, but it's also accessible and engaging. So that's the other part of it. So that's in a nutshell, that's part of it.